So we rolling.
Rolling, rolling, rolling. Gotta keep them doggies rolling.
Ed Witt, what's up, Shalawam? We out here in good old Columbus, Ohio, at Ohio State University campus. Shit is crazy, you know what I'm saying? So we about to bring out some scripture.
Give all praise to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai, which is the name of the Father and Son.
Yeah, because if you ain't coming in that name, you ain't coming in the spirit of truth. You know what I mean? The end of America is nigh.
No, it's not.
Hey, you got Psalms 49:11. Psalms 4, she said it's not near.
She's like, no, it's not.
The old raggedy broke down hoe said the end of America is nigh. I said America's end is nigh. She said, no, it's not. Like she knew. Like she knows what's going on.
Yeah, she got them Diane
Yeah, she's just like a old washed up whore. Don't know what's. She ain't got no knowledge. She ain't got
an experienced cocksucker. Yeah.
She got Jezebel prophecies.
Oh, yeah. You see what happened to Jezebel? She got thrown out the goddamn window and trampled on by horses and ate by the dogs. Then the dogs went and shat her out after they ate her. And we've had the best trip. Get Psalms 49:11 for these old fools.
Psalms 49:11. Their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever, and their dwelling places to all generations.
Yeah, because all these people in America, they living a good life. They got good jobs and stuff. And they think that this raggedy country is going to continue forever. They ain't got a clue about what's going on in the world. They ain't got a clue that Russian fighters just buzzed by that. You seen that, the Russian fighter.
Destroyer.
2 days in a row. First, they buzzed by the destroyer, taunting them, like Daniel, like, let's get this going.
That's right.
And then, was it yesterday, a Russian fighter jet buzzed by an American fighter jet.
Yeah.
It was threatening.
It went by the American surveillance plane.
Yeah.
You know,
the Russians.
Spy plane.
Russians was bold, bro.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And what did America do about it?
Right.
Nothing. Because
they didn't do shit.
Because they know as soon as they do something, Russia's going. They gonna pounce on them.
Oh, they can't do shit but talk shit.
That's all they can.
That's all they did. You know what? Because the article that came up, America said they could have shot down the plane if they wanted to. Well, why didn't you, big bully? You know, the big bully is being exposed as a bitch.
Yeah.
You know.
That's pretty much what Russia did. Pull their bitch card.
Yep.
Straight pull their bitch card.
You finished?
Yeah, that's the point on that.
Okay, here we go. Ezekiel 12:21. And the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, what is that proverb that you say in the land of Israel, saying the days are prolonged?
Oh,
see, that's
yeah.
just Israel. They just think this shit is just going to be prolonged. It ain't going to happen in our lifetime. It's going to happen when biblical time ends, you know? They say when biblical time ends. But he's still in a fucking biblical time.
Hey, man, 2,000 years since the Lord was here. Don't you think it's about time?
2,000? 2 days? Okay, the day, I was waiting for that noise to settle down. The days are prolonged and every vision faileth. You know, tell them therefore, thus said the Lord power, I will make this proverb to cease. Now this shit gonna all cease, this bullshit, the prophecies ain't gonna happen, the Bible ain't nothing but bullshit, ain't nothing but a fairy tale book. So when all this shit starts happening, when all this chaos and madness and bloodshed start happening in this sorry ass cesspool of a nation, America, then you're gonna say, oh shit, what's going on?
They gonna be looking for Bibles. You know what I'm saying? They gonna be busting out. They gonna have every version of the Bible they can find. They be searching.
Right,
you
right. The gay version.
Yeah, they gonna be
all American homosexual version.
Right, right. Right. Esau Sodom version, you know. Here we go. Tell them therefore, thus said the Lord power, I will make this proverb to cease, and they shall no more use it as a proverb in Israel. But say unto them, the days are at hand, and the effect of every vision, for there shall be no more any vain visions, nor flattering divinations within the house of Israel.
Oh yeah, like all the, you got all the prosperity preachers giving them false prophecy, saying, They always like to use that scripture, ask and you shall receive.
You gotta plant your seed.
All they do is preach prosperity. They preach that.
That's all they do.
That you're gonna be rich if you trust in the Lord. Mm-hmm. And you know that America is gonna is the greatest
gift
of God. You know what I'm saying?
Right. That's what them motherfuckers do, man. They get a demotion at work or bills behind. Oh, I'm going to church. You know, I'm gonna pray on this. I'm going to church and pray on this.
And giving their tithes too.
Right. Yeah, ain't got shit to pay the bills next.
They can't pay the bills, but they're going to pay that.
They're going to pay them tithes. Yeah.
And the taxes.
For I am the Lord, I will speak, and the word that I shall speak shall come to pass. It shall be no more prolonged. For in your days, O rebellious house, will I say the word and will perform it, said the Lord power.
Yeah, because our people is rebellious. They don't never want to do what the Lord has commanded. These raggedy-ass heathens out here don't even keep the Ten Commandments. They're a bunch of adulterers, adulteresses. You know what I'm saying? Just a bunch of wicked demons.
A bunch of hypocrites.
A bunch of hypocrites, heathens.
Again, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, behold, they of the house of Israel say, that's funny how he didn't say those are the house of Esau or Moab.
Amites.
You know?
Nah, he's specifically talking to Israel.
That's right.
From Genesis to Revelation.
That's right.
Of the whole book.
Son of man, behold, they of the house of Israel say, the vision that he seeth is for many days to come. And he prophesied of the times that are far off. He's calling the Lord a liar, pretty much. They're two-thirds. Therefore say unto them.
Oh, that's like people like your dude, Nate, Nathaniel.
Right. Oh, rich man.
He's getting all that dude from IUIC on the internet, on YouTube. He got this church. They all dress up in purple, and they look like Foot Clan ninjas from the Ninja Turtles. Right, right. But he's like taking up offerings. He's trying to raise like a few million dollars so they can build what, a university or something?
I don't know.
Black Wall Street.
With him a plane too. I don't know.
Yeah, he tried to get a jet aircraft carrier.
A plane too.
He was an aircraft carrier.
He wanted a grocery store.
Oh, that's right.
So he thinks that it's not far off.
Sell some GMO food and shit.
Yeah, he must have never read that scripture.
Right, right. Therefore say unto them, thus said the Lord power, there shall none of my words be prolonged anymore, but the word which I have spoken shall be done, said the Lord power.
So the word of the Lord is going to be done. And the word of the Lord, America is going to be destroyed by thermonuclear destruction. That's going to come soon. Soon America is going to be no more. It's going to be turned into a pile of ashes. Mm. And you know what I'm saying? If you ain't right, you're going to get turned into a pile of ashes too. You're going to get burned up.
Oh shit. Going to get Jeremiah 16:3, bro. Get this over.
Yeah, I got a precept for you.
This is a lot of reason. It's just firing the whole thing, man.
Hey, can I get a precept real quick?
Go ahead, bro. You know, this church welcomes precepts.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's encouraged heaven.
Yeah, yeah.
We can't be reading no Bible.
Oh, like, not like when I went to.
We're out here discussing Jesus.
Well, I was at Peraza's. I tried to bring out a precept. He's like, no.
Right. He did the same thing, trying to bring out precepts around Peraza's.
Like, we try to get all the precepts we can get.
Precept upon precept.
We ain't got enough time to even get them all.
Hey, we're trying to feed your foods. You know? We're trying to feed your foods.
Matthew 16:1. The Pharisees also came, the Sadducees came, tempting, desired him that he would show them a sign from heaven. Because these fools, they ain't going to believe nothing unless you show them a sign. They be like, well, if you a prophet, then to have God strike me dead right now.
Oh, God
damn. You know?
No, that day's coming when you're going to be like, okay.
And pow!
Right.
You're going to hit with, the Lord going to hit you with that pow.
A pow!
Yeah, it's going to be a wrap.
That's right. And it's coming too.
Yeah.
Why they in doubt?
He answered and said unto them, when it is evening, ye say, it will be fair weather, for the sky is red. And in the morning, it will be foul weather today, for the sky is red and lowering. O ye hypocrites, ye can discern the face of the sky, but can you not discern the sign of the times? So, I mean, if you watch the news, like we just talking about Russia. Russia keeps provoking the United States. Okay, you got all kind of wars breaking out all across the world, revolutions, uprisings. Yeah, but you can't see that. You're retarded.
You know what I'm saying, man?
I mean, you're
I mean, there's chaos everywhere, man. I know, fuck.
But check this out. Matthew 16:4. A wicked and adulterous generation seeketh after a sign, but there shall no sign be given unto it but the sign of the prophet Jonas.
You know about Jonas.
So that's for that sign they're going to get.
Yeah.
He's going to get fucked up.
Right. Here we go. Matthew 11:17. And saying, 4:16, but whereunto shall I liken this generation? It is like unto children sitting in the markets and calling unto their fellows, and saying, we have piped unto you, and ye have not danced.
Yeah.
We have mourned unto you, and ye have not lamented.
All right, because you supposed to be out here, we out here singing a song, you supposed to dance to the song,
yeah.
Meaning you supposed to listen.
You have not lamented.
Yeah, because you should, we in lamentation out here.
Right.
We supposed to be mad about these fucked up living conditions, not having no money. The government takes damn near all the money you get. You know, everybody likes it, so though. These people enjoy their slavery. Matter of fact, they'll help contribute to their own slavery, ensure that they stay slaves.
You see just, something, say something.
They will bend over backwards, you know, to make sure they stay in slavery. Because they love their slave masters. They really do. Look at these people. You just look right at these people. They're just worthless. You look at them. Just worthless zombies.
A docile state of mind.
Yeah, they're docile. They're just... just
amazing,
fucking useless eaters. Just
amazing.
Fucking.
Is there more of this?
Just actual, we're surrounded by actual mental retards. Look at these mental retards down here. Look, check out that big crowd of people down there. That's what I mean by useless eaters. You see that they're actually all waiting in line to get a piece of pizza.
That's an abomination with pork on it.
Yeah, but it's not a lie. It must be the best pizza ever.
Yeah, who the fuck waits that long for
fucking
pizza?
Yeah, they're trying to be
pizza.
Cool, right.
They see everybody else doing it, so they're going to wait a fucking
because they
big
just,
ass
line. Yeah, I could go right down the street. There's a pizza shop right down the street.
I told you, man, don't be surprised, man. They already secretly, how they talk to each other, they probably, we got baby fetuses on this pizza and ejaculated all over it. And it's the hottest shit around.
They probably did. They probably got a closed
and
Facebook
everyone in line they know about that's on there.
Right. And everybody, majority of these people is a fucking sodom. The majority of them are sodomites, so they're going to fuck to that shit, man.
Let's go get some cum and pepperoni cheese pizza.
Right, right. Don't think I'm just saying that.
I mean, it sounds crazy,
though. And bizarre, but this is a bizarre-ass people, man. It's a bizarre. America is a bizarre world.
It sounds crazy as hell, but, I mean, Bohemian Grove is crazy.
Right, right.
You know, these Greek fraternities are crazy. You know what kind of wild shit goes on in them fraternities? They be in there ass raping each other. They be in there
butt chugging.
They be in there having sex with animals.
Anal chugging.
Because if you want to be successful in America, you got to be part of a fraternity. You got to be a Freemason. You got to be part of some kind of fraternal order, a secret society if you want to make it. That's a fact. Almost, how many presidents came out of Skull and Bones? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, John Kerry, George Bush, your cousins both came out of Skull and Bones. George Bush Sr. There's a lot more high government officials than that came out of Skull and Bones. They say to be elected president, first you got to go to Bohemian Grove, participate in the cremation of care sacrifice. It's where all the elites gather together in the woods, run around naked, have sex with each other. And then at the end of the day, they go sacrifice a baby to Satan.
The motherfuckers say that baby screamed as a recording.
Oh, you know that's real.
Right, right.
You know that's real.
Right. Ask Howard Jones, he told you he was there. He got invited.
Yeah, he got it on footage. He got the footage.
Let me record it.
He got
proof. And it was just something clever they did. Let him in and record it. Just so he can take it out to the world and deceive the world like he's some truth seeker or some, you know, or some revolutionist or some freedom fighter or some shit.
He's full of shit.
Full of shit.
Hey, his show used to be halfway decent. Now
it's all Miss Esau. Miss Esau.
Man, that show used to be halfway decent, but now all he talks about is politics.
It was at one time, wasn't it?
That was all politics.
Yeah, yeah. Donald Trump this.
Now it's just like Fox News on steroids or something. It's just some bullshit. He turned the show into some bullshit.
Some bullshit.
Now all of his guests are a bunch of faggots. They used to have interesting guests on there. Sometimes he still does, but I ain't trying to hear that shit no more, man.
You're waking up to the truth, man. You see everybody's mad. It's bullshit.
Yeah, you see right through the lies.
You ain't, see it all,
you ain't gonna deceive us very easily.
Right.
Not at all.
Here we go. This is Job 5 and 19. For he maketh sore and bindeth up, he woundeth and his hands make whole. He shall deliver thee in 6 troubles, yea, in 7 there shall no evil touch thee. In famine he shall redeem thee from death, and in war from the power of the sword. Thou shalt be hid from the scourge of the tongue.
Yeah, so that's what's coming, is all these things that he just mentioned are coming soon. Famine, war, death, destruction. And the famine, that's the big one though. That's the scariest of them all. It's one thing to be destroyed in war, that's a quick death. But famine?
Yeah, get your head blown off. You ain't gonna know your head blown off.
You know what I'm saying? When you sitting there starving, you watch your little children starving, they dropping dead.
Stomach
growling. And then some people gonna eat their own children. You know, some people eat their brothers and sisters. Brother killing brother over a can of spinach. You know what I mean?
Shit, they see a cup of water just sitting on a empty house.
Yeah, they'll fight over that.
A little glass cup with brother, a fly sitting in it. They gonna still fight.
Yeah,
and kill
brother will kill brother over there.
They gonna fight and kill brother. Ain't a motherfucker gonna grit and drink something here.
Yeah, share.
You know.
Not these demons.
He take the fly and worm down with it.
Yeah, these people are savages. They was raised up with no morals to begin with. You know what I mean? So, y'all had no problem doing that.
I can't wait, man. I can't fucking wait. The Most High bring the terror on these people.
It's going to be beautiful, man.
That's right.
Ain't gonna, you know what I'm saying? Ain't going to be no scoffers on that day. That's finally when the day of no scoffing. It's going to be the best day in history.
Yeah, that's when these people's worst nightmares going to come knocking.
Yep.
Their worst nightmares, you know, and the Most High knows it all. He's here, he made these motherfuckers.
You ain't gonna find us on that day.
Hell no. We're gonna be chilling. Here we go. Neither shalt thou be afraid of the destruction when it cometh. At destruction and famine, thou shalt laugh. You know? Wait a minute, this is the Most High saying this. We're gonna laugh? That means he gonna laugh.
We gonna laugh.
Right. He told these people, man, you better do something. Better rise up against your fucking enemies.
So the Most High, man, that's why I love the Most High. You know what I mean? That's why I love the Bible, man. If you don't love that, you're just a big faggot, man.
They don't love that.
They
gonna make sure that Bible get rewritten, that scripture get taken out. At destruction and famine thou shalt laugh. Neither shall thou be afraid of the beast of the earth. I'm saying Most High is going to raise up animals against these motherfuckers.
Yeah, because the animals going to be hungry too.
Hey, how many zoos is in America, across America? Anybody know?
I don't.
You know what? The day's coming, those zoo animals going to come right up out of there. And it's going to become your worst nightmare. Lions, tigers, and bears. Mine! Lions, tigers.
It really be, no. Bro.
What's that?
They already
be getting you.
They already be getting you.
Wild beasts, you know, newly created beasts.
Yeah, there's some strange creatures on the earth. Esau thought he done discovered every species. He done cataloged every species on earth. I was watching documentaries down in the Amazon rainforest, and a Jake down there said that. He's like, the white man's never went up in here. We seen creatures that you've never seen before. They said they seen a monkey with a human face. The shit out there that will blow your mind.
Some Amazon, that shit is thick.
That's crazy out there. Yeah, they can't go up in there.
Yeah, they can't.
Esau can't even survive up in the rainforest. The mosquitoes will tear his... The mosquitoes don't like Esau. They'll tear his ass up.
Yep, there's been families of the elites flying in their helicopters over that shit and never seen again.
They can't get in there.
Right, yeah. Their helicopters, the planes crash. You know, because freak accidents happen and they never seen the families again.
Yeah, because you always got Esau going out in the Amazon looking for the lost cities and lost ruins.
Or looking for some animal to fuck.
Oh, yeah.
That's Esau.
Looking for some...
Esau looking to do the greatest
thing. He always want to... You know, saying... He's always up to no good.
I can hold this, man. Go ahead. We can go back. Go right back to that.
Go ahead.
Yeah, whatever, bro. If you got a beast scripture, animals killing people or something.
Yeah.
Well, whatever, man. Just bring
it. Wisdom of Solomon 11:17. With thy mighty hand that made the world of matter without form, once it not mean to send among them a multitude of bears or fierce lions.
Multitude.
Can you just imagine looking at one of these fools just getting mauled to death by a pack of hyenas?
I can imagine. I can visualize it, you know?
You can see him ripping their eyeball out. Just
I can imagine sitting there watching you like, damn! Flopping. That lion eating that motherfucker's eye out.
They're screaming while their intestines is hanging out. They're still alive.
Right, right.
You know?
Wild beasts. It's gonna be what y'all gonna do when these wild beasts come torching? Coming against y'all, the boogeyman. The boogeyman.
They said the boogeyman. Hey, the Most High is the real boogeyman.
Because you know what? I like talking to these motherfucking men that think they hard and shit.
Talk shit to
them. Because the motherfuckers, the scripture said these motherfuckers going to be like bitches in the day.
What's like that women. One? Most High says take up a proverb against them. I'm going to see if I can find that.
Going to be like bitches.
I got it.
Going to be running and going to see some lion pack of motherfucking rhinoceros behind, and he going to escape right. He gonna be crying. He gonna barely escape. And next thing you know, some fucking pride of lions on the roof coming down after his ass. It's gonna be these people's worst case. The worst situation you can think of, man. The Most High bringing these motherfuckers.
I got it. Look, Habakkuk 2:6. Shall not all these take up a parable against him? A taunting proverb against him?
This says taunting?
You got a taunting devil. You know what I mean? A taunting proverb against him and say, woe to him that increaseth that which is not his.
That's right.
How long? And to him that layeth himself with thick clay.
Hypocritical thieves.
There goes Josh.
Hypocritical goddamn thieves.
Turn that bullshit off.
Yeah, turn that bullshit off. I'm trying to hear your bullshit.
2nd Ezra 9:7. For, and everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith whereby you may have believed shall be preserved from the said perils.
What's up, y'all? Give you some magical pizza? How long it take you to get that?
An hour and a half.
It was it worth the wait?
No.
Oh, no.
I mean, how they advertise that for y'all to rate the line?
Facebook.
Is it free?
What did it say on Facebook?
You get a free pizza? Well, you got it for free?
Yeah.
What's on really?
Pepperoni? Anything you want.
But what's on yours?
Like pepperoni.
Oh,
and,
man.
Yeah.
I was going to ask for a slice before you said pepperoni.
We're doing it till 10.
Right, right. All right.
So you just got to get some information, though, you know. That's why they was online. This shit was free.
Still,
I knew it was a catch behind.
They might run out of food.
You probably did check off Mansfield though.
Oh,
they
shit.
They do shit like that.
Yep. Remember when LeBron James got dished by Papa John's and they were giving out 23 cents pizza?
Man,
I already got it. Let's get weird.
That's a distraction. That's what that is.
It is.
So women ain't supposed to run around like that. You see?
Damn, look at your boy.
Scripture says these women will make a man fall out of his wits.
Yeah, you know? Yeah, they will.
You see shit like that, man?
That's the motherfucking Batmobile.
Old friend of mine.
That's why we got here teaching. You got to stay focused. Sometimes the Lord is sending this big voluptuous thing by you. Somebody come up and talk to you. Try to, you know what I'm saying, throw you off the rails.
You off the spirit.
Yeah. Yeah, but you know, I've seen shit on the YouTube about Jake working in these fast food restaurants, and they get caught after a. Yeah, he get caught jacking off in the food and the sauce that.
Right.
And motherfuckers get caught and they've been doing it for years.
Yeah, it's a dude that got caught jacking off in the salad bar somewhere. I don't know if it was Wendy's, because Wendy's used to have a salad bar.
Just think of how perverted our people are. They do that more than you think. They do it in the fast food restaurants, the food factories, everywhere.
Yeah, I told you my brother pissed in the lemonade at
Yeah, I remember that. I can't remember the name of the place.
It was one of the restaurants anybody can afford to go to. I can't remember the name of it.
That gives you even more reason to pray before you eat.
That's mine coming, bro. I claim that one. You see how thick that is. Yeah, Israel's stupid and wicked, man. They don't even realize their wicked things they're doing for a laugh. It's just that same thing that's going to get their head blown the fuck off by a missile.
Yep.
You know?
And yeah,
before that missile hit them, that memory most I can put that same moment in a hologram in front of them. Or might just place them in that same moment again, pissing. You that's know, why wind time on them and shit.
That's why the Lord called them a wicked and adulterous generation. Our people are some fucking freaks, man.
See pepperoni pizza sitting in the J-shaped right now.
I'll hit it. I'll claim it.
She gotta go to the rehabilitation center.
Send that bitch to rehab.
Yeah, cause when you get with a woman, you gotta, you really do, bro. If you gonna get with a woman, you can't let your woman eat pork. You know what I mean?
She's gonna do it secretly.
Well, she'll, even if she better, you better not let her do it around you at all. You gotta let her know. Don't be teaching her, or trying to teach her or nothing, but you can't be letting your woman eat pork. That's nasty. You know what I'm saying? Because then every time you lay down with her, that's like laying down with a hog. You know what I mean? Lay down with a pig.
Boss hog.
Claim.
Boss hog on the
my shit with a claim.
Boss hog.
And everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith, whereby you have believed, shall be preserved from the said perils, and shall see my salvation in my land within my border, for I have sanctified them for me from the beginning.
That's beautiful.
Then shall
that's
they
a lucky suffering God.
Then shall they be in pitiful case, which I mean cause, which now have abused my ways, and they that have cast him away despitefully shall dwell in
it. Abused his ways, there's no law, so we ain't gotta follow the law. I mean, that's just straight up madness, that stupid ass common alone.
I had somebody hit me with that this morning on YouTube.
No law.
Cause I just put up a video about eating pork last night, and somebody came on a comment board like, what do you mean? So we have to keep the laws? I'm like, I came back with him like, well, the New Testament is 2,000 years old. That's kind of old, ain't it?
Right.
And the Old Testament is even older. And the Ten Commandments is in the Old Testament. So, I mean, so we're not supposed to keep the Ten Commandments either because it's so old? You know what I mean?
That's their logic,
that doesn't
man.
Make sense.
Hey, that's their logic, man. That's some crazy shit.
Let me get a quick precept for that real quick. See if I can get to it. I really need a new Bible. Go ahead.
For such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me, and they that have lost my law, while they had yet liberty, and when as yet place of repentance was open unto them, understood not, despised it, the same must know it after death by pain.
Yeah, by pain. And let's see y'all. And they ain't gonna escape that either.
That's right.
Ain't no escaping that one.
Don't think we feel when we given power after coming out here all this time and the motherfuckers we've been scoffed at, shit thrown at us.
Hey, that's true.
You know what I'm saying? What you think we're gonna do after we receive power, man? Motherfucker, you still eating pork, huh? Nah.
What was that? You got a Christian
just
flag?
Your hand, a fire, a lightning strike will come out your hand like a sword, you know? That's spiritual power.
Yeah, we're gonna have our heart's desire. So if you wanna have that Castlevania whip in the kingdom that's all got fire and ice ability, well, we're gonna have that, you know what I'm saying?
I was watching that new Dragon Ball Z with Frieza, man. His powers, where he uses his powers more spiritual. Because people
Frieza?
Fall off Frieza, yeah. I saw him swing at some people up on a mountain. He just swung his hand and the whole mountain was chopped in half.
Yeah, Frieza ain't no joke.
Frieza bad, man. That's too bad, they keep killing him, man.
Frieza and Cooler.
Yeah, they brothers too.
We know they both cold.
Right,
you know, like
right.
The other Dragon blood. Ball characters are all named blood. After vegetables. Yeah. Goku means Kakarot means carrot. Goku means carrot.
What?
Kakarot means carrot. Gohan means rice. You know that Gohan means rice? What's the other one? Well, Vegeta means vegetable.
Seriously?
Yeah. And then some of the other characters are named after clothes and underwear and stuff. It's weird,
amazing.
Man.
That's some amazing shit.
Because I was, cause my sons was real into it, and I started, they got a Dragon Ball Wiki. So, yeah, they put a lot of thought into that shit.
Right.
That's some more useless knowledge for you.
Hey,
I got a precept though. Romans 3.
There's people on YouTube that argue with you about Dragon Ball
Z. Oh, yeah.
Your Chinese bitch religion. Over there.
They want to fight
people,
over it.
It's like people argue with you about Star Trek and Star Wars.
Oh, which one's better?
Religious fighters. Religious. I mean, they're following religiously, man.
You see your Chinese bitch over there?
Yeah, she all decked out.
Go to them Comic Cons, man. Them Comic Cons. people dress up and they call off work. Actually, they plan the whole week off vacation to go to the country.
They call it cosplay.
Yeah, that's it.
They dress up like Princess Zelda. And
yeah, it's a religious thing. It's a religious thing.
Yeah. It is. The girls be getting it in. They go up there, they all dressed up. Dressing up like Final Fantasy characters.
They're gonna be looking good,
yeah, they be looking delicious.
Don't.
You got clean lie. They be looking delicious. Even though they ain't supposed to be wearing that shit. Oh yeah, that's why I said it was. She looked like one of them, like
North Korean dancers.
Oh, right here?
Yeah.
Oh,
that's Chun-Li. But check this out, Romans 3 and 31. Do we then make void the law through faith? God forbid, we establish the law. That's what we was just talking about, how people, they say you're allowed to eat pork. You don't have to listen to the commandment in the Old Testament because it's old. That's what, that's in the Old Testament.
Yeah, because you got old people that follow the Old Testament and you got motherfuckers that follow the New Testament. Combination of both of that crazy shit.
Man, it's all, the scriptures say we come in a volume of the book. It didn't say we just come in, you know, one half of the book. It didn't say that. But man, because why would you even want to eat pork to begin with? That's the most fucking disgusting thing you could ever put in your fucking body. You cook it, it stinks the whole house up. You look at the grease it leaves in the pan, it leaves grease this fucking thick. That's going right to your arteries. It makes you fat. It makes you stink. Why would you do that to yourself?
Yeah, it kills you slowly too.
Niggas always talk about, you know, you talk about weed and shit, it's all healthy for you.
Yeah.
What the fuck, why you eat pork though?
Oh yeah, your weed's so healthy. Well, the weed's gonna offset the pork.
That's the only thing they talk about healthy is when it gets them higher, taste good or some shit.
They say
that's knowledge of a savage individual.
They'll use that, yeah, but they're smoking nothing but blunts too.
So those are precepts of men.
It's the only plant they fucking know.
And then they use the scriptures to butcher the scriptures to justify.
And they always use the scripture that says that you can eat herbs.
Yeah, eat herbs.
If you want to do it right, we should make some tinctures or something out of it.
Here you go.
I like one of them.
Luke 6 and 40.
No, I'm talking about them tinctures.
Oh.
He's looking like.
Luke 6 and 46. And why call ye me Lord, Lord, and do not the things which I say?
Yeah, God. Oh, pastor, be up in the church. Lord, the Lord spoke to me this morning. And I seen the loud. Yeah, and the people, they're the dumbass people. They eat it up. They love it.
He said, I see the loud.
Ow. The loud.
Woo wee. They do. They see it.
Oh, I talked to the Lord this morning. He said, boy.
Right.
You gotta go to the church today and give them this message.
Oh, shit.
You gotta sow your seed of faith. Donate $50, $100, $150, donate $1,000. Leave us in your will.
Right.
That's how they get it.
Leave us in the will, damn. Yeah, that's pastor. That's the righteous pastor. That's the righteous pastor. Look at her singing.
She getting it in.
Yeah. Waiting for that vintage, you know, that vintage. Look at her, look at her.
Jesus Spirit, don't go fucking nobody think. Hold on a second, Lloyd just gotta go. He's about to get
it. Shaking his hand at us and shit.
Romans 7, this is Paul speaking. This is Romans 7 and 22. For I delight in the law of God after the inward man.
There you go. The inward man.
Leviticus 11 and 7. And the swine, though he divided the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he cheweth not the cud, he is unclean to you.
Yeah, that's nasty, man. Eating pork is filthy, man. Go ahead.
Of their flesh shall ye not eat, and their carcass shall ye not touch. They are unclean to you.
That's one of the worst things you can put in your body. Okay. It's like if I see a woman eat pork, I'm not even gonna touch her. Don't even try to, let alone kiss her. I'm not even gonna touch her. You know, you stay away from me. You know what I mean? You goddamn heathen. I don't care how good you look either. You eat pork, I'm not dealing with you at all.
Shit, bend that bitch over and then kick a step. Nah, pussy gonna smell like it.
Yeah, it gonna smell like bacon.
Here you go, this is Joe 14 and 4. 14 and 3. And dost thou open thine eyes upon such one, and bringest me into judgment with thee? Who can bring a clean thing out of an unclean thing? Out of an unclean, not one.
That guy, you can break that down on multiple levels too, man.
Yeah.
Because people is always trying to mix uncleanliness with the truth. You know, they always try to say it's okay to eat pork, which is an abomination. They'll say they got churches that got faggot preachers now. They got gay preachers. You got women preachers. They celebrating Easter, celebrating Christmas. They're not doing nothing right. They got it all wrong on all levels. They ain't get a single fucking thing right.
Not a goddamn thing. Nothing. They say to eat pork, they say cooking it.
Yeah, cook it.
For long periods of time, for the right amount of time.
Yeah, they could.
You know,
they
makes it healthy.
But they said they could cook it right back in the day. Like, they didn't have fire 2,000 years ago.
Oh, that's a recent invention, huh?
Fire? Yeah, they just now got fire in the 20th century.
Right.
That was, the fire was part of the Industrial Revolution. They discovered fire. They
discovered fire.
Yeah, people are fucking retarded, man.
Dumb as shit.
You just
fucking dumb as shit.
And you know when people will get caught, but then
Jehovah's Witnesses.
Where? Oh, them is Mormons, bro.
Mormons, yeah. That's what I mean.
They got some poor helpless woman. Look, get her.
Got her.
She looked dumb as hell too.
Got her.
She ripe for the picking, boy. They gonna get all up inside of her mind, brainwash her and everything.
They
want to meet her brother.
Oh, right.
Check out your boy.
That's Mr. Esau. We've been seeing him since
he was a man. I'm calling Mr. Esau. Mr. means master. That's the thing too. People don't know the meaning of words. So they go, when your children go to school, they make them call the teachers Mr. Well, Mr. means master. That's an old slave word. You ever watch that movie Django? What did they call Leonardo DiCaprio? DiCaprio, Monsieur, which is the French way of saying Mr., which means master. So don't ever call anybody master. The Lord said, call no man on earth master. There's only one master, that's the Father that's in heaven. Because rabbi means master, right? Rabbi means master. So you always have some faggot Christians, they'll come up and be like, well, you're lying to me. That's not what my rabbi said. So if you know someone's calling themselves a rabbi, the Lord is not dealing with them, okay? Yeah, that shit sounds
horrible.
I noticed that's the new popular way to rap these days, is to slur all your words
and
to sound like a retarded as possible. It's to mispronounce your words as worse as possible. You use the least amount of words, use the most simplest vocabulary possible. And it's just to sound as retarded as possible.
Shit, that, we think that's a formula they came up with. Nah, they just stupid.
They just stupid, exactly.
You know?
It's not a that's beautifully said. They're retarded. So if you got number retards, their music will reflect their mental retardation.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it ain't hard to figure that shit out.
You know what I'm saying? Just look around, man. People's retarded. I mean, they're actually, like, retards.
That's harassing.
It's just speaking the truth, man. Ain't nobody got a lick of sense out here.
It is better to hear. It is better to hear the rebuke. Damn it, brother.
That's a good scripture, though.
It is better to hear the rebuke of the wise than for a man to hear the song of fools.
What you read on?
Ecclesiastes 7.
Yeah, because when somebody comes up here, we start talking to them, and we tell them to eat pork is wrong, and then they'll get in an argument. Oh, no, hell no. That's the Old Testament, nigga. I'm gonna do what I want. You know what? Read that again.
It is better to hear the rebuke of the wise than for a man to hear the song of fools.
So you're supposed to do what we say. Because we're just saying what the Lord said. We're just reiterating the facts. Okay, we just repeating what was written. So you're supposed to listen to us.
That's right.
Okay? We don't want to hear the song of fools. Every time you come up here talking your bullshit, talking about what you believe in, that's the song of fools. We don't want to have no part in the song of fools. We ain't singing that song.
But as a crackling of thorns under a pot, so is the laughter of a fool. This also is vanity.
Yeah, the laughter of a fool, man, that's an irksome vibration, you know what I mean? When these fools come up here heckling and laughing, that vexes your spirit, man.
It is, you motherfucker. So you use the scripture to shut that laughter down. Wicked motherfucker. That was a jig.
Yeah. You see that look in the eyes.
You finished with that, bro?
Yeah.
Where's that? Hold on. Ecclesiastes 8:17. Start 16. Strive not with an angry man and go not with him into a solitary place. For blood is nothing in his sight. And where there is no help, he will overthrow thee.
All right. You can't trust any of these people either. You know, you hang out with 2/3. You know what I'm saying? You don't get the reward of 2/3.
That's right.
Which is death. They're going to take you back in the alley. They're gonna rob you, jack you.
Unexpected.
Shoot you. Rape you.
That's the worst. Just gonna scream them around. Totally unexpected.
Yep.
While they slip you some Mickey or something, while you laying there fucked up, they got you. Consult not with a fool, for he cannot keep counsel.
Dude, she walked by us like we was the filth of the earth. Did you see the look on her face? She was like this. She was like
which
this.
One? Which one?
That fine ass bitch will walk by. She did this, bro. She did.
Right.
She's like, she didn't even want to breathe while she walked by us.
She's going to be looking for us in that time.
Oh, she is.
You know, remembering how she looked at us, crawling toward us, apologizing.
Oh, I got a scripture for that.
She's going to get kicked in her head, you know?
Pow! Pow, bitch.
Still go good. Longest still go in history, 79 yards. Kick her fucking head off. Poof! It ain't gonna be one of them kicks I used to do in the early days, 60s and 50s, early 70s. I used to go straight and kick the field goal that way.
You would do that to such a nice, beautiful young lady?
Hell yeah, now they coming pretty with it.
Hey, they coming pretty with it.
Motherfuckers in soccer, man, they got them kicks down.
It's like that Ohio State punter. They got the best punter in the country.
Buckeyes.
I forget his name. You know his name? He's an Australian dude. That motherfucker's bad. He'll punt the hell out of that ball. Just with accuracy too, with accuracy. He'll lay it down right on the 1 yard line.
Yeah.
I don't know how he does it.
Right. That's all he's been doing is kicking his whole life. And not kicking and blocking, that nigga just been kicking shit.
I got a scripture. Daniel 12:2. And many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. So a lot of these people in the kingdom, they gonna be in the kingdom, but they gonna be shameful.
Israel. They the baddest scoffers of them all. Israel gonna feel stupid. That's a terrible feeling to have, is a feeling of shame, man. That's a terrible ass feeling.
2:27. Be not weary, for when the day of trouble and heaviness cometh, others shall weep and be sorrowful, but thou shalt be merry and have abundance.
I know that girl. I think we cursed her out one day. Across the street. That's that bitch. That's that demon bitch. Is that a rapper bitch? She's a demon though. She's like Satan, ain't she?
I think I was on the side. I think I was in the camper. Yeah, she had like a skateboard.
Was that her?
Yeah, it looked just like her. She cried. She went back right here.
Yeah, crying. We've been seeing her for the longest time.
Yeah, I've been seeing her for a minute. I couldn't remember. I remember her. She cussed us out once, didn't she?
This, I don't remember that.
Maybe I'm wrong. I don't know.
Well, she probably did, though.
I thought she did.
She probably did, though.
I thought she got right up in her faces.
Yeah. I don't.
Yeah, you know, it happens so many times, you forget.
Right.
Scoffing ain't nothing new. We expect it. Actually, we welcome it. We welcome the scoffers and the scorners. Anybody want to scoff and scorn? Come on, bring it on.
Bring it on.
We thrive off of that. That just means that we were successful in our mission.
Just give us some excitement.
You know, give us some excitement. Give us a good something to laugh at. Because these people think they coming up like they got us. When we was the one to set your ass up. You know what I mean? Because really, essentially, we're trolling for truth's sake. You know, you like trolling people. Like when you're on the internet, you troll people's comment boards. Which means troll, you mean you fuck with, you send up a taunting proverb like that Habakkuk said. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Damn.
She looks sad. Yeah, she looks like she's in bad shape, man.
You know she just got it.
Yeah.
She probably just got rammed. She got the train ring on.
Proverbs 3:7. Be not wise in thine own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. There should be health to thy navel and marrow to thy bones. Honor the Lord with thy substance and with thy first fruit of all thine increase. So shall thy barns be filled with plenty, and thy presses shall burst out with new wine. My son, despise not the chastening of the Lord, neither be weary of his correction. For whom the Lord loveth, he correcteth, even as a father the son in whom he delighteth.
Oh yeah, like him right here. This brother right here. We first met him, we cursed his ass out.
Yeah, that was terrible.
He said that was terrible.
We got the video on our channel. I don't know, it was way, a couple years back, but.
I look stupid as hell.
Well, that takes a man to admit that.
But you know, I was surprised. No, I was mad. I was mad as hell at him too. Like, this guy is retarded. And I was amazed when he came back out, admit, you know. But hey, you praise the Most High for that.
Yeah.
You know?
That's when the angels rejoice,
bro. That's when the angels. Oh, let's get that scripture.
That's when the angels literally rejoice. It ain't they just happy. They up there, they rejoice. You know?
Brothers in LA, you know that, what's that, Worldstar, how they got put the video on Worldstar?
Yeah.
Some dude woke up from watching that.
What? The same one they put on Worldstar?
Yeah.
That's a bad video, though.
Yeah, that shit was sweet.
Yeah, that's hard. That's a hard video,
what
man.
Video
was
that?
Was on fire. They was the spirit of the Lord was straight up in that video, wasn't it?
Well, he took what's video?
Because I watched it 100 times. I can't, this one they would just curse them up.
Yeah, that's
out.
One that went viral.
Just curse them up.
That's one of the ones that went viral. What, it was like a parade or something?
I don't know.
Most hateful group and something like that.
Yeah, right.
I think I did see that.
It's like something different.
That's bad, bro.
I didn't try to do it to the brothers in Chicago. I was hoping. What's that scripture that says that you ain't doing nothing against the truth, bro?
Right.
Man, I was just reading that. I can't ever remember. Because that's the one where he said, those that are not against us are with us.
It's funny how they think they're actually doing something to deter you, but actually helping the word. Just like the dude, remember the dude down here in OSU put the video of us up.
Oh yeah, that was years ago. That's still on Live Leaks.
Right, right. He said, behold, guys, the Israelites. Because he had an introduction to it.
Oh, I've never seen that one.
Yeah, he said, behold, guys, the Israelites. And here we started talking.
Remember that one guy came out and interviewed us for the school newspaper?
The girl, too. Remember the girl, too?
Yeah.
The girl, too.
I do remember.
There's a girl and a guy. There's a girl and a guy.
And I gladly, you know, I did the interview. Let's get it in. Because we boggled that dude's brains, man. He came up here. He was all fucked up.
Because he was silent the whole time.
Yeah, he was silent. He couldn't believe what he was saying. Because everything he said, I had to correct him. Like, no.
Nah, bro.
That's not the way it is. Yeah. Well, this was years ago.
Yeah.
That's what we do. We turn people's world upside down.
He was out here the whole time interviewing us, man.
Well, actually, we turned their world right side up. They're living in upside down land right now.
I found that. This is Romans 13:8. Okay. For we can do nothing against the truth.
Yes, sir.
For the truth.
Here go your girl right here. Here go your girl.
Look at your girl on the skateboard. Getting it.
I ain't playing, bro. You see that?
She was showing all fucked up. She failed.
Failed? She probably got pushed down the steps.
Yeah, she got fucked up. We're gonna thighs on her, man. We're gonna legs on her, man. Like a skateboard.
Oh, she all strong and shit.
She healthy, man.
Yeah, she healthy.
Healthy.
That's what you want. You don't want one of these women that's just all fat and sitting at home eating pork all day. And
shit, in 5 years, she ain't going to look like that.
Nah, yeah, give her time.
I got some
more of
this.
We got
that.
Wait, let me get that.
All right, let me
get. What you have?
First Corinthians 13.
Right before you get that, let me bring this out. Like, well, I just got a precept, something he said. Luke 15 and 10. Likewise, I say unto you, there is joy in the presence of angels of God over one sinner that repenteth. You know what I mean? Just so people be like, ain't nobody even listening to y'all.
Right.
Like we don't know that.
Right.
Like we don't know that.
Right.
Like we know this. We know nobody listens.
That's right.
But
that's right. That's right. That's right.
All it takes is one person to wake up and we're good.
That's right. And that's why the angels rejoice, because it's so rare. You know?
It's not a common occurrence. Right, it's not, right. People just don't wake up like that every day.
Right, right. Hey, let me tell you something. Let me go fishing and be out there for a few hours and not catch nothing. When you finally catch something, watch how your
right eyes go up.
You know? Happy as fuck.
Yeah, because first you're going to catch a raggedy carp, throw it back. You catch some of these
trash.
Motherfuckers might eat it. Yeah.
Catch some trash.
You catch a rubber dildo. I see somebody post that. They was fishing it. You catching tires, right? You catching a boot.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Catch a raggedy ass little bluegill.
Yeah. Those are boots they pulled in from Florida, guys. Yeah. That's trash. You fall out, you ain't part of this no more, so you're part of the world. The world is trash.
That's one of the major, the Lord compared us to fishermen though.
That's right.
Because he said, I'm going to come with me, follow me. Actually, he seen, what was it, Peter fishing, right? And he was out there fishing. And he said, hey, put your net down, stop working, and come on, follow me. I'll make you fishers of men. And that's the old church song. You ever seen that song?
Yeah, let me read it real quick. Matthew 4, 18.
Fishers of men.
Yeah,
17. Fishers of men.
From that time, Yahushua began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And Yahushua, walking by the Sea of Galilee, saw two brethren, Simon called Peter, and Andrew his brother.
Oh, that's what it was. Yeah, so Simon and Andrew.
Right. Casting a net into the sea, for they were fishers. And he said unto them, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men.
And keep on. What did they do? Did they sit and think about it? Like, hold on, maybe after I'm out of college, I'm gonna do it.
Give me your number. I'll text you later.
Yeah, just give me your number. I'll text you. Just give me a link. You know what I'm saying? I'll follow you on Twitter.
Right. The Lord had a urn to throw him out. Hold on. Let me get your number, man.
Yeah, nah.
Was that when he said, let the dead bury the dead?
Yes. I don't know if it's right. I don't think it's right there.
And they straightway left their nets and followed him.
Yep.
And going on from thence, he saw two brethren, James, the son of Zebedee, and John, his brother, in a ship with Zebedee, their father, mending their nets, and he called them, and they immediately left the ship and their father and followed him.
Yeah, said the hell with this, man.
Jeremiah 16:16.
But they must have been some bumites, though, because, man, you got a bunch of Israelites on YouTube. They'll make fun of if you don't have a job, or, you know, obviously you should get a job, you know, help pay for shit. You need money to buy a camera so you can make YouTube videos. Oh, shit. The truth is what you are beholding.
I believe it. You do? Sandy Hook books? Sandy Hook too?
Oh, yeah. You know about the conspiracies?
No.
You know the 9/11 was an inside job, right?
Yes.
That was behind. That was the Jews behind that, and they run the government. Yeah, they control the whole world. Who owns all the banks? So-called Jews. Where's it at? They're not even real Jews. They're actually Edomites. Hey, get Revelation 2 and 9. You see this? With Jews, you lose. You know what I'm saying? That's some valuable information.
They control the whole world, so they control all the power of every nation, the militaries, the police, so they're able to make their own rules, own laws, everything goes. Whatever they say goes.
Yep.
You know, whatever they say goes. So they got these people up under them that take orders that's willing to do these false flag, whatever.
Oh, then they blamed it on
the church.
This is church this right is here. Church. Yeah. This so-called Christian churches, that's not in the Bible. The Bible says nothing about building a pagan temple, because those are all pagan temples. And they celebrate Easter. You know, Easter is the name of a Germanic goddess. She's the goddess of the spring.
So who are you guys?
We're Israelites.
The real ones.
You ever hear the Israelites?
I said go with the Jews.
Well, the Jews is just short for Judah, which is the head tribe of the nation of Israel.
Yeah, those people over in Israel are denigrated.
They
know the benefits of being Israelite. So the real Israelites, they erased out of their minds through years and years of captivity. They erased out of their minds that they're the Israelites. So they took on that identity, knowing the benefits of it. It's just Esau just trying to get the birthright back. When the birthright is nothing he can do to get the birthright from who it was promised to, man.
Yep.
You know? This man who controls the world is a fool. He's stupid.
Fool.
The man that controls the world, the Edomites.
Full of pride. You
know, they're stupid. They're foolish people, just like Job says. They're people full of pride. They're foolish people. They're base people.
Yep. Hey, bring the scripture out again for edification.
He's out of here.
His wife gave him that look, and he just started walking.
I was about to read this real quick, Acts 7:48. How be the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands,
Oh, yeah, because all them churches, the Lord ain't up in them churches. Oh, I was just reading. I just made a video. There's this bad book out there. We got to get this. What's a good book? You know, bad means good sometimes.
Right, bad. That's bad, man.
Yeah.
Just Jake talking.
Yeah, he'll say, that's my shit, even though shit, that's excrement. Shit. But that's my shit. That's how fucked up our language is.
Well,
that's
slang.
Yeah.
You're like, oh, that's nasty.
Just because I call someone a motherfucker doesn't mean they fuck mothers. That means they're the mother of all fuckers. Just a fucking asshole. I got lost my train of thought talking that madness. What was we just talking about? Oh, yeah, these churches. All these churches are... there's this book out there. I just made a video about it. There's this book called Pagan Christianity with a question mark. And this is just this thick, juicy book. It just goes in on how modern Christianity is pure 100% paganism. Wow. No doubt about it. It just got reference after reference after reference after source. It's just like very meticulous book, right? And I found this book inside of a church. So they know about it. Because everything in these churches is pagan, from the design of the temple or the design of the church. It's not a church, it's a temple. The word church means a congregation, a gathering, a calling out. It's when, because back in the early days of the truth, when brothers first start, right after the Lord was crucified, and, you know, he got beamed up. During the early church days, people used to gather in their homes, kick it, drink wine. They didn't have no long, drawn-out ritual where someone came out wearing a robe, lighting incense, lighting candles, speaking in Latin, and all this crazy shit. They didn't do none of that. They didn't have pews. They didn't have podiums. You know what I'm saying? They didn't have everybody rise up and pray. No. Nothing like that at all. What it was what we're doing right now, is this. Came into the world to save sinners. Hey, she's right, but you know, they don't know nothing. I mean, they're retarded. We're surrounded by retards. You know, there are people, they got a... let me get it. Because our people don't know nothing. A lot of these people, there might be some decent people in them churches, right? That might be hard to believe for us, you know, to know the truth, but... But some people, they... I'll just get the scripture that explains it. Now, Romans.
That motherfucker is just like Gomer Pike.
Gomer turned out to be a tranny.
Fucking
guys, Gomer Pyle is a fucking tranny.
Gomer fucking Pyle.
Wow.
Woo.
This is sick.
I gotta show you.
This nation needs destroyed just for that. Look, Romans 10.
Your boy coming over here.
But this is the point I got right quick. Romans 10:1, brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they might be saved. That's the sinners, is Israel. For I bear them record that they have a zeal of God, but not according to knowledge. So these people, they got, they believe in the Most High. You know, they know God is real, okay? They know the Most High is real. But they got no knowledge. They're retarded. They don't realize that Easter is a pagan holiday. They don't realize that Christmas was the supreme devil worshiping day of Satan. They don't, you know what I mean? Oh my God. Is that Gomer Pyle?
It's Gomer Pyle.
Look, Gomer Pyle, get that on camera.
It's Gomer Pyle. What's Gomer Pyle?
That's.
Looks like Caitlin.
Dude.
They probably dated at one time.
That was probably Caitlin's inspiration.
Gomer Pyle.
Oh my God, man.
Gomer motherfucking Pyle. He old as shit.
That fucked my spirit up seeing that picture. That's some nasty shit right there.
And he was a singer too.
He was in the family friendly show too. Andy Griffith, just a happy, good old family show for the whole family. Sit down and watch the fucking training.
Gomer fucking Pyle.
Cause Jeff, he was doing that. I bet you, he was dressing up with Andy Griffith.
Yeah, Andy was probably.
And Don smashing. Knotts was getting it in with him too.
Yeah, they were smashing. Yeah.
Just think about it. Old grandma probably joined in with that sick old
Aunt
bitch.
May.
Aunt May was up in there.
Aunt May.
You know Aunt May was a freak. You know that. You know she was a freak. They put they're called actors for a reason.
Yeah, Opie gay too. He openly gay too.
Who? Opie. Talking about the director?
Opie, yeah. He directed so much shit, man.
Yeah, he's like the master director.
Opie. I don't know his motherfucker's real name.
Ron Howard. Yeah, he done directed a billion movies. Made some damn good movies too.
Ginger.
Yeah, Ginger. Ginger bitch. Yeah, you ginger bitch. He has no soul. I ain't be getting it in though, man. But let me read the rest of this. Romans 10:2, I'm gonna read it again. For I bear them record that they have a zeal of the Most High, but not according to knowledge. For they being ignorant of the Most High's righteousness, and going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of the Most High. For Yahawashi is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone that believeth. Well, that's the point, though. I mean, these people, they don't know what's going on, man. They ain't got a clue. The people are clueless. And most of our people don't even believe at all.
That's the church folk, though.
Yeah, the church folk. That's, you know, for the church folk right there. And they're experts on Jesus. I know I know about Jesus.
Himself
the truth shall set you free.
And whomever
they leave out the first part.
Did they?
Yeah. The first part is, if you are my disciple.
Oh, there you go.
They left that out.
That's Esau for you.
That's the important part, yeah.
Well, these colleges are built upon deception.
Well, there's a lot of Christians here, but it's a lot of...
But, you know, the modern-day Christian, though, is just pagan.
Wow.
They all celebrate. Do you celebrate Easter?
We just did that a couple weeks ago.
You know, Easter is the name of the goddess of spring, right?
You know that the days of the week and the months of the year are all about all pagan days, too?
Yeah,
well, then you need to use first day, second day, third day.
That's what we should do.
Is that what you do?
That is what we do amongst each other, yeah.
Okay, good.
We don't celebrate Easter.
Well, if you look at the early church,
they didn't celebrate Easter. They cursed Easter.
You about to justify Easter?
I'll tell you my interpretation. Thank you, Jesus, for celebrating.